Hey everybody, this is Cedric with Paracrew, and today I'm going to show you how to fix your double-clicking mouse. This problem usually occurs with mice that have been in use for a while and need their tension springs readjusted. I'll be showing you how to do that fix on my Logitech G300 mouse, but the same method applies more or less to any mouse out there. Before we begin, make sure you have a flathead screwdriver, a Phillips screwdriver, and a pair of tweezers at hand. First order of business is opening up the mouse. In my case, I have to remove the rubber adhesive pads from the bottom, then remove the screws underneath, and finally pop the plastic shell on top. Once the top has been removed, you will be able to see the mouse's PCB, where all the electronic circuits are located. In the front, you will see a couple or more black rectangular boxes with little white buttons on top. This is where your left and right mouse buttons are supposed to be. These black boxes are what we call switches, and inside them are located the tension springs that we need to readjust. We now need to open the switch we wish to fix. To do this, just use the flathead screwdriver to undo the plastic latch in the front of the switch and lift the plastic cover slightly. Then do the same thing to the latch on the backside of the switch. Make sure to do this very gently, because inside the switch is the little white button and spring which might fall out when you do remove the cover. Sadly, I wasn't able to get this part on camera, so I'm showing you how the cover is when removed, so you can see the latches. When the cover is lifted, you will notice a little copper tension spring being kept in place by three metal arms. Gently remove the tension spring from the mechanism and notice the curve on the bottom. We now need to bend the curve slightly upwards to give it more tension. I'm using my nails to get this done, but you can also just put the spring down and bend the tab upwards using a screwdriver. Once this is done, it is time to put it back in place. Now this is where things get tricky, and you'll have to be a bit patient. You need to place it back in so that it is held under the metal arm in the front of the switch, the curve in the middle is sitting with tension against the middle arm, and the back is sitting under the back arm. My preferred method for doing this is starting from the back, adjusting the curve in the middle, and then applying pressure with my thumb in the front to make it sit in place, and finally gently using a screwdriver to adjust it so that it sits in place correctly. Alternatively, you can start from the front arm, then use the flat screwdriver to adjust the middle, while also making sure that the back of the tension spring remains under the back arm. When this is done, use the tweezers to place the white button back into the switch cover, and then gently at an angle, place the cover back over the switch and close it. At this point, you can test that the switch works as intended by clicking the white button with your screwdriver. If all went as planned, you can then close the mouse and plug it in back to your computer. If you need a set of instructions for reference while performing this fix, I have a link down in the description of Firm's guide that shows you how to perform the same fix. Keep in mind that you might need to repeat this sometime in the future, and also if you have a soldering iron and deem it necessary, you can always buy replacement switches for your mouse online. That was it for today's video, everybody. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up below, and also get subscribed for more awesome videos. I'll see you in the next one.